Sonia B. Sanchez. Replace the spacer every 6 to 12 months. I've had my spacer for 5 plus years. Whoops. Lol. Sonia, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Use a Spacer Device video. Well, I'm glad you now know that. And I'm glad the video helped you because, well, that's the whole point of it. Thanks for commenting. Welcome to another episode of Responding to Your Comments. We're gonna be looking at funny questions. We're gonna be looking at health questions. So what are we waiting for? Let's do this. Annika Acharya. Oh God, I have a fever and I have finals coming up. A quick question. Does vitamin C help a cold? Annika, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Treat a Fever video from a while ago. I think with vitamins, you have to be very careful because a lot of the times, there are a lot of unproven claims that I see on packaging. So for example, it'll say things like boosts immune system, helps burn fat, gives you energy throughout the day. And it happens a bit too often in my opinion. And also it's not right. However, there are certain situations where vitamin supplementation is required. So for example, when your vitamin D levels are very low, then supplementation of vitamin D is required. And also if you live in the UK, for example, during autumn to winter, a vitamin D supplement is also recommended. And for various different conditions as well. So for example, if you have malabsorption, where your body isn't able to absorb the vitamins, then it's recommended then as well. But generally speaking, by the way, that wasn't a full list of all the times that you should take a vitamin. But generally speaking, if you need a vitamin supplement, your healthcare professional will let you know. So if you're fit, you're healthy, you're living a healthy, balanced diet, everything's fine, then generally speaking, a vitamin supplement isn't required, so you can save your money and spend it on your next holiday. Sorry, Annika, I feel like I've gone way off your question, but we'll go back to it. So vitamin C for colds, do I recommend it? No, I don't recommend it. Does it help prevent a cold? Does it help you recover faster from a cold? Because that's sort of claims that I see on the packaging for this kind of stuff. The simple answer is no, not really. There's very little evidence that supports any of this, so I wouldn't recommend it. Also, I do remember not long ago reading a study about vitamin C supplementation and it increasing the risk of kidney stones in men. So that's another reason to sort of stay off it as well. I will also leave a really useful link by the NHS in the description below, and it explains all the different vitamins, what foods they're in, whether you should take supplements, where you shouldn't. It's really, really helpful, so I'd highly recommend everyone reads it. Thank you for your comment. Chris Burgess, love your videos. Time to shave that facial hair though. Chris, thank you for your comment. This one definitely got my attention. It was from the headaches video. I don't know. I think the best thing to do is to leave it to you guys who are watching. If you think I should shave off the beard, leave a comment below. If you think I should leave it, definitely leave a comment below. But Chris, thanks for your comment. Gaming Buddy, is it bad eating junk food? I eat it every day. Gaming Buddy, thank you for your comment. This is from a previous Respond to Comments video. Eating it every day, yes, it's very bad for you. You see, the thing about junk food is it's very high in calories, but does it have a lot of vitamins? No. Does it have a lot of minerals? No. Does it have a lot of fiber? No. So what does this mean? Well, it means that if you're gonna eat every day and not in moderation, then it's gonna cause things like obesity, it's gonna cause things like diabetes, it's gonna cause heart disease, and many more conditions. This comment actually reminds me of a recent article I read in The Lancet, and it was about a 14-year-old boy who lost his sight because he was eating junk food every single day. And if I remember correctly, I think he went to the doctors and he was complaining about tiredness. So they did some tests on him and they found out that his B12 levels were really low. So they were giving him B12 injections and they also gave him dietary advice, but unfortunately he didn't follow. Now, a couple years later, he then presented with blindness, blind spots, and color blindness. Now, the specialist then did a lot of tests to find out what was the cause of this. And it came down to nutritional optic neuropathy, which is basically damage to your optic nerve caused by nutritional deficiency. So because he was eating junk food every single day, because he wasn't getting enough vitamins, because he wasn't getting enough minerals, that was the cause of this optic neuropathy. And I guess it's important to remember that this is very rare, but if you are eating junk food every single day, then please rethink it. And I will leave a useful link in the description below, which is all about dietary advice, which you might find helpful. Asia Mariam, is drinking hot water good for constipation? Asia, thank you for your comment. This is from the constipation video. I do remember reading a while ago about drinking sort of hot beverages, and apparently it does help to cause relaxation and contraction of the bowel. So I guess it could help with constipation. But a more important thing to remember is about drinking hot drinks. I don't know if any of you guys saw, but it was a massive study done recently. I think it was on like 50,000 people over 10 years. And they were drinking 2 to 3 cups of tea every single day. And the temperature of the tea was about 60 degrees or above. And they did this for 10 years and they compared it to people who were drinking their tea at a lower temperature. So after 10 years, they found out that those that drank at a high temperature doubled their risk of getting esophageal cancer. So we now know that you should leave your tea, let it cool, or any hot beverage, let it cool, and then drink it at a sensible temperature. Fruit Loop dude, blanket too hot. No blanket too hot. Foot or leg out of the blanket, demons or monsters will grab you. Fruit Loop dude, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Sleep Faster video. Yeah, I've been there loads of times as well. Sometimes you have a blanket on, you're boiling. Actually, I'm there right now, actually. Sometimes it gets so hot and I turn the AC on. Then I turn the AC on, I'm freezing, and I switch it off and I'm hot again. So there's no happy medium, unfortunately. Luckily, no demons or monsters have grabbed me. Thankfully, they don't exist. But thank you for your comment. Thank you for all the great comments. We're getting nearly 5,000 comments per month, which is quite a lot and quite a lot to read through. So if I missed your comment, I'm really sorry. Leave another comment and I'll try my best to get back to you on a future episode. Always remember that you're awesome and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.